Hello, YouTubers, and welcome to another episode of Let's Build Disneyland. In today's episode, we will be focused on actually starting to pave the roads. And here you can see I started on the top left kind of alleyway next to the fire station, and I'm using gray stained clay as the main pavement for the roads. I just think it gives like a nice gray texture while still not being too dark but not too light. I think personally to me the gray stained clay is one of the best blocks in the game. I really like to use it. I wish I could use it more, but it's definitely good for pavement, concrete, clean yet more industrial looking builds. And in this case, having it be a road is perfect. So you can see I'm filling in the areas in between my black wool outline. And I'm just going to be filling that in and then going back and replacing the black wool with these stained clay. This is just to make sure that I know where everything is going to be placed. I could replace all the black wool before I started building, but either way it would work. It works either way. So here I'm just going from inside the central courtyard to the outside, near to the regular buildings. I'm only going up partway right now, but then later on in this video you'll see I go down the street more. Pretty much I fill in the entire street all the way to the central hub of the entire park. Just so that I can keep everything kind of on camera. So here you can see I'm kind of digging into the pavement because I am planning on putting in the tracks for the streetcars. And usually you would think just use the regular minecart tracks. But I decided to go a little bit different with this one. I've used this technique before, and it turned out pretty well there, but I used it again here, and I won't spoil it yet, but I'll have to say I really like it. And I've actually had friends already see it, and they have complimented me on it. As you can see right now, the technique I use is using stone brick stairs in these little cutouts that I use. What that does is it gives both the track but also an indent into the road, so you can kind of think that's where the wheels of the carriage would go as it's going along the track. I just have always kind of enjoyed this little technique. It gives a little bit more interest into the pavement than just it being a flat, regular design. So here we're working on the long part of the road. And here instead of going from filling in and then replacing the outline, I just decided to replace the outline straight off. And I started off with the center because I already knew I was going to be having to put the tracks in, the stairs. So I left those areas open for when I do have to go back and place those stairs. So yeah, just continue filling in. You can see off in the distance there's a fire blazing. and just keep going. This is kind of the tedious work. Now I'm just filling in the stairs. Once in a while I'll miss a block, so I have to go back, fix it, and then keep going. Just a little bit of tediousness with this stuff. And so there we have it. This is what we have so far with the park. As I've said, please like, favorite, share, comment. do anything, I'm not going to be, I always ask it in these videos, and I say this every time, but I only ever ask for a live favorite comment share only in this set of videos, because since it's such a huge project, but in most of my videos, I don't. So please, like, favorite, share, and subscribe, etc., etc. And I'll see you guys around.